Hi there guys, welcome back to a brand new tutorial by myself, Mr. Feudal. Today we're going to be hunting and we're also going to be learning about snares and animal traps. I hope you enjoy this tutorial, I hope you learned something, thanks very much for watching. Hello there folks, welcome to the hunting tutorial. So today we're going to be talking about the early stages of hunting. Now can you see in front of me there's a big elk or a deer? In fact, this is considered a passive animal. So the first weapons you really get in this game are quite simplistic. So here we have the primitive knife, which is going to be used to skinning, the sling ammo, and obviously the sling. So the sling is relatively easy to create. Now you just need 10 plant fibre and a stick to create this. So here we go, we're going to go try and belt this thing with our stones, our sling ammo. So here we go, I'm just getting myself into position here. Here we go, come on. Set it up. Oh, we missed. This is what will happen with a sling. A sling is not the most accurate of weapons. I hit him there, I hit him a good hit there, hit him for 13.7 blunt damage. Now blunt damage does take a while to affect the animal. So going back to what I said about the deer, this is a passive animal. This animal will basically run from you if you try to attack it. The same goes for things like the sow, which is the female boar, a sheep, a ram will actually defensively attack you. Hares are passive creatures, grouse are passive creatures. The Aurochs cow is actually a passive animal as well. The bull will charge you if you do attack it. Okay, so geez, I'm not getting good hits on this thing. But anyway, passive animals are quite interesting because some will actually stand their ground and fight back. This one, for example, this elk or deer or buck is not actually fighting back. I am actually outside the radius where it can flee, so I'm taking advantage of this. I'm not doing a very good job, however, because I keep missing him. I got him there. Anyway, for passive animals as well, what will happen is they will get to the point where they think they're at the lowest health. They're at their lowest possible health. They will turn and attack you. They will actually turn and physically attack you. But for passive animals, they will stay put if you stay put. If you chase it, they will flee. They will run very, very quickly. They are always going to be faster than you, regardless if you have high willpower or high agility. So, I'm not doing very well with this thing, am I? I'm just watching this. Wow. Oh, I missed that one. The slings are relatively inaccurate, as you can possibly see. I got him there. The sling is quite inaccurate, but it's the best weapon you're going to be able to use early on in the game when you've not got an anvil and forge set up. As you can see, I stepped inside his radius of flee there, so he started to move. Right guys, I'm going to just speed this up a little bit to get rid of the, you know, missing part. Okay, can you see he actually made a really, really growly sound there? There he's charging me. I'm starting to actually fear that I'm going to get hit here. Yep, I'm going to get hit. Look how much he'll hit me for. Look at that. Look at my health deplete. That is my soft HP going down. If he hits me enough, he'll actually down me. Uh-oh. Right, one big tip for you guys, early players in this game. Run to water. Watch this. I turn around. Look, he doesn't follow me. He just stands there. This is a bit of a cheating method because I don't have the necessary equipment to actually kill this thing. But there we go. We downed him with blooming blunt ammo. So it took a lot of stones and a lot of hits. Remember, you'll need your skinning knife or your basic primitive or iron knife to skin this thing. Then you can go down to general actions, open. And there we go. Now, usually if you're high enough level, you'll get the head, you get the horns as well. There's the bones. Now, I'm actually carrying too much here, so I'm just going to limit down how much I'm actually going to carry here. So there we go. I like even numbers. Drop that. And I'm going to take the head, because the head can be used as a decorative piece. So thanks, guys. Thanks for watching this part. Next part is semi-aggressives. Hi there, guys. Welcome back to the second part of this hunting tutorial. So right now, you probably can't see it, but there's boars in front of us, or a boar and a sow. The boar is a semi-aggressive creature. If you get within its aggro range, it will charge you and it will do a lot of damage to you, as you'll find out in a second here. The sow, on the other hand, as I said in the first part of this tutorial, is a passive creature. It will not attack you unless you attack it. So here we go, we're going to wind up and try and hit this thing. Oh, good shot, good shot. But you hear that? Now he's raging. Now he is angry. So the tip for this is try and bait him to the coast. What I'm doing is I'm baiting him up the hill. Now look at the amount of the hits that he can put on me. The amount of damage that he's dealing at the moment. I've actually pressed flee here and I'm moving up the hill. So as we move up the hill, we'll get the better ground on him. So here we go, here he comes. He's charging up the hill. He's a wee bit slow because he's fat. There we go, he stopped. So what we can do is we can move up this hill and we can wait until our disablement from flea is deactivated, and then we can start hitting him again. So I just want to say, guys, thanks a lot for watching this. All of my videos but getting great feedback. Cheers for every comment, every like, even dislikes, and everybody calling me a mongo. I don't mind it. I love it. It's brilliant. So here we go. We've got our stuff ready. We're just waiting for this disablement to go off. It's 5 seconds. So we're going to wind up. We're going to hit him. And what I'm going to do here, guys, is I'm just going to speed this up until we've actually got this damn thing killed. So bear with me. Right, I'm almost dead here. Well, I'm almost knocked out. One more hit and I'm going to get killed. Or, I'm not going to get killed, I'm going to get KO'd. Watch what happens here. Right. Let's wind up to hit him. I know I'm going to get knocked out here. Here we go. And I'm knocked unconscious. Look at him gloating over my body. Right, this is what happens when you lose your soft HP. You get knocked out. And when you're knocked out, you can't do anything. Now, unfortunately, I've disabled the numbers on my health bar, but you would see it as negative 5 soft HP, and that will slowly climb until you get back on your feet. Now, to regain soft HP, sit down, you can see it rapidly coming back up to meet my hard HP. What I'm going to do here, guys, is I'm going to speed this up until we kill this damn boar. Okay, guys, I've drawn him all the way down here. I have got very little soft HP. What I'm going to do here is I'm going to use the water, again, like the first part, to my advantage. So wait for the disablement to come off and we'll hit him here and we'll bait him right to the coast or right to the water. Watch what will happen here. Good hit on him there. I hate the running effect of this game when you're in your combat stance. Looks like you really need the toilet. But anyway, he's charging us and we're going to run right onto the water. Right, watch this. Right? I'm not on the water right now. Now I'm on the water. I'm off the water. Look what's happening here. Because this boar doesn't want to access get in the water, I'm using this to my advantage. I'm basically sponging all the hits here. Some people will say it's a cheating method, but it's the best way to down an aggressive animal like this. It is the best possible way to do it. Luckily, I ran out of stamina in the blooming water there, otherwise I might have been KO'd. Right, we'll keep hitting him. We'll keep hitting him. Come on, down you damn thing. Whoa, nearly. He's almost dead. I know he's almost dead because he's starting to flee now. Oh, he's running. He is running. Oh, that could have been a great hit, that. Oh, he stopped. Why can I not? Oh, I know why. I've ran out of ammo. Okay, so notice how I can get quite close to him. Look, I'm running right beside him and he's not charging me. He's now fleeing. I have to pick up some ammo here, guys, so bear with me. I just have to pick this up, pick up about 20 or 30, and then we'll get back to smashing his face with these stones. Okay, I'll take 30. Quickly attach them, because we don't want this thing to regain its health. It can regain its health relatively quickly. So here we go. And throw. And he's dead. He is down. Down for the count. Oh my god, that took ages. Look at my health. So, again, you need your knife ready to skin him. Semi-aggressive animals are annoying as hell because they do the most amount of damage, or blunt damage as I find. There we go, we get his head, we get his tusks, we get his meat, and we get his hide and his bones. Bones, very useful for creating monuments, hides for leather, and the heads and meat, well, heads are for decorative pieces, and the meat, obviously, for eating. Next part, aggressives. Okay, hi there guys. Right, I've just found a bear and I'm not taking any chances with this. My recommendation for killing aggressive animals, use a bow. Use a bow and get to the coast as quickly as possible. Right, I'm using broadhead arrows as well. Ooh, he's angry. You'll see him there, he's charging. Imagine seeing that in real life. You would drop and run. Keep shooting this damn thing in the face. Use broadheads, they are the best arrows against such big animals. They will do a lot of slashing damage. Again, using the water to your advantage, just keep shooting the damn thing. We're shooting one of the poo here, and there he's down. That's the easiest way to kill them. Get a bow, a simple bow, a short bow, composite, long bow, any kind of bow or a crossbow, and you'll take these big grizzlies down. Easy. Okay, so this was probably a bad example of an aggressive animal. I have been searching for an aggressive animal for ages. I've not found any wolves. I've not found any other bears apart from this one. So I've just taken the plunge and started attacking them. So again, get your knife out. Get ready to skin this thing because this is going to yield a lot of resources. So open that big thing up. And there you go. You get a bear head. You get 197 bits of meat. Is that 197? Am I blind? Yep, that's 197. So, there we go, guys. Next part, snares. Okay, guys, welcome to this part where I talk about snares. Now, snares are basically small traps used to catch chickens and hares. Here you can see I've got 10. They're pretty low quality, pretty poor. I'm not expecting to catch many with these. But anyway, there is a little theory that if you place these snares like away from buildings, away from civilization, you'll have a faster rate of catching animals. Now I'm gonna test this. 5 on the edge of my border, away from my buildings, I'm also gonna put 5 right up against my wooden warehouse. Now we're gonna see what happens in this a wee bit later. After I've set these snares, I'm gonna show you guys a wee bit about traps, animal traps, and what they can actually be used for. But anyway, I'm gonna set these last 5 snares up against my warehouse. Here we go, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here we go. Now, I'm gonna test this out, and I'm gonna see if it works. Now, I've never found this theory to be correct, but we're gonna find out anyway. So, I hope you enjoy this next part, guys. I hope you enjoy the traps part, because this might make you laugh. Thanks again for watching, folks. Okay, guys, so this is the traps part of this tutorial. Now, you're thinking, animal traps. The key word is animal traps. Animal. No, these are not for animals. I mean, you could use them for bears and larger game, but I'm going to tell you exactly what animal traps are for. They're for humans. Yep, that's right. Look at this. I'm going to place down 2 here, right? And I'm going to show you exactly why they're for players. Now you can see them. They're traditionally looking like bear traps. Watch this. Watch what happens when I do this. 68 slashing damage. I am pinned to the ground right here. I can't move. I literally can't move. Until this disappears, I can't move. There we go. I'm free. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how much health you can possibly lose by 2. Now, I'm just going to set my home quickly because I've not done it. Here we go. Here we go. I might die here. Oh, there we go. Another 68 damage. I must mention I've got a high constitution on this character. That's why I'm surviving these hits. But yeah, animal traps are actually used or designed to trap players. Now, use them like you would in Rust, for example. Place them in places where you would not expect people to, well, where you would like to channel people into. So, thanks for watching this, guys. Thanks very much. I'm going to include the snares part here. I'm going to have a wee sit down and heal up. Thanks again for watching. Okay, hi there, guys. Welcome back to the tutorial. After healing myself up, I've discovered that none of my traps have actually triggered, as you can see here. Look, they have not triggered whatsoever. You probably can't see them. Anyway, I just want to say thanks very much for giving me all the positive feedback on my videos. It's been great getting back into this game. All the feedback from the community, from all the guys that I've played with as well, all getting back into this game as well. It's been absolutely brilliant. So, thanks again, guys. If you've got any problems with this tutorial, leave a comment in the comment section. If you enjoyed the tutorial and if it helped you whatsoever, give it a big like. If you want to follow through in my other tutorials or my soon to come tutorials as well, hit subscribe, ring that wee bell. I will be releasing more tutorials, more gameplay, hopefully more on the MMO as well. I'm Mr. Feudal, guys. Thanks for watching. See y'all later.